Hello children, welcome to the English class of 8th standard third language. I hope you all are ready with your textbook, pen, pencil and notebook. Okay children, now shall we sing a rhyme? Okay, the rhyme is about crow. Now I am going to recite a rhyme. First, you listen carefully. Okay, children? Fine. Shall I? Okay. I am a crow with feathers black. I want to grow with little Jack. I am a prettiest of all the birds. I am the smartest of many words. I am the grace in my way. Who cleans the place all the day? I am a crow with feathers black. I want to grow with little Jack. How is it, children? Nice, na? Okay. Now it's your turn. You have to repeat after me. Are you ready? You have to say after me. Okay? Okay. I am a crow with feathers black. I want to grow with little Jack. I am a prettiest of all the birds. I am the smartest of many words. I am the grace in my way. Who cleans the place all the day? I am a crow with feathers black. I want to grow with little Jack. I want to grow with little Jack. Did you all enjoy the rhyme about crow children? Very nice. Now, let us see a story related to crow. You all are familiar many stories with the character crow, isn't it? Among those stories, let us see a one story of crow. In this story, there are two characters, that is the crow and the fox. It is familiar for you, no? See, look at the picture. The crow is sitting on a tree. Yes, children, listen carefully. There once lived a crow. He was very hungry. The crow was searching for food. His eyes fell on a piece of cheese. He quickly swooped down, picked it up and flew off. While flying, he sat on a tree. He sat on a tree to enjoy the cheese. Just then, a hungry fox saw the crow on the tree holding cheese in his mouth. Look here, the fox. Look here, the fox is looking at the crow. Cheese is there, isn't it? Then, what happened? Emmy, the cheese looks delicious. What I would do to get that piece of cheese? The fox thought. The fox decided to use all his cunning means to get that piece of cheese from the mouth of the crow. He sat under a tree. Look here. He sat under a tree. Spoke very politely. He said, "Hello, friend. How are you?" But the crow didn't say anything. Then the fox. Crows are such lovely birds. "You are very charming too," said the fox, flattering the crow. Then the crow didn't reply anything. Again, the clever fox thought of something and said, "I have heard your voice is sweet. Please sing a song for me." The foolish crow opened the mouth to sing the song. Here, see, look at the picture. The foolish crow, look here, the foolish crow opened its mouth to sing a song. The cheese, look here, the cheese. Yes, the cheese fell down. The fox took the cheese and went away. Yes, the foolish crow opened the mouth. The cheese fell down. The fox took and went away. See how cunning, no? How bad the fox is. The crow worked hard. It searched the food and finally it found a cheese. But while sitting, this cunning fox used all his cunning nature and grabbed the cheese from the crow's mouth. What the fox did was the right thing, children. No, na? Yes, we should not take the things from others. If they are willingly giving for us, we need to take. We should not forcibly take. We should not grab the things, isn't it? Wild children. See, one such incident happened in Guru Nanak's life. Let us see, what did Guru Nanak did when he saw the sannyasis who were suffering from hunger? Okay, children, let us continue the lesson where we had left in the earlier classes. Now, what you are supposed to do means you are supposed to look at the screen. Don't look into the textbook. Okay. First, look at the screen and listen carefully. Are you ready, children? Very nice. Now, I am going to read the text. You listen carefully. Before moving to the text, let us look up into the new words. Okay. The first new word of today is starving. Starving means suffering from hunger. Starving means suffering from hunger. Look here. Starving. ಹಸಿವಾಗೋದು. ಏನೋ ಒಂಥರ ನೋವಾಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ನಮ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಹಸಿದಾಗ ಎಷ್ಟೋರ್ಸೆ ಭೂಖ ಲಗಿಸ್ತೇವೆ, ಜೊ ಪೇನ್ ಹೋತಾನಿ. ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್. ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಂಗರ್. ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೇಕ್ ದ ಯೂಸೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಮಮ್ಮಿ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ಹಂಗರ್, ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಶೌಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಟು ಯರ್ ಮಮ್ಮಿ? ಮಮ್ಮಿ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ. ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದ ಪೂರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್. ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ದ ಪೂರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಂಗರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ಹಂಗರ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಟನ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಹಂಗರ್ ದ ಪೂರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ವಿಂಗ್. ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ರೆಡ್ ಕಲರ್, ಎಸ್ ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಎ ಎನ್ ಜಿ ಇ means strange. Today's second word is strange. Strange means surprising, unfamiliar. Strange means surprising, unfamiliar. Okay children, aparichita. Okay na? Now let us make the usage of word strange into the sentences. And today's our first sentence is, we should not speak to strange person. We should not speak to strange person. ಅಪರಿಚಿತ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳೊಂದಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಾತನಾಡಬಾರ್ದು. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್, ದರ್ಗಾ, ಫೇರ್, ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೀ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಂಜ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಯಾ I awoke to find myself in a strange room. Look at the girl, she is sleeping in a room. Suddenly she awoke to find myself. I awoke to find myself in a strange room. Okay, now let us move to the third sentence, that is pleased. Today's third word is pleased. P-L-E-A-S-E-D. Pleased means happy. Pleased means happy. Happy andre khushi agodu. Happy andre enagodu? Khushi agodu. Okay. Oh, you are coming? I am so pleased. Look at the boy. Oh, you are coming? I am so pleased. Nu bartidiya? Nan thumba khushi aagtide. One more sentence is there. He looks pleased. He looks pleased. Look at the boy. He looks pleased. Okay, children. Let us move to the fourth word. Servant. S-E-R-V-E-N-T. Servant means domestic worker. Namge kelasadalli sahaya martaralla avarna naavu servants anta heltivi. Domestic worker. Who help us at household works and all, we say servant. Okay, look at the picture children. The servant in Taj Hotel dressed neatly. The servant in Taj Hotel dressed neatly. A servant take care of my child. A servant take care of my child. These were the four words that we are going to see in today's text, and we have known its meaning and the usage in our sentences. Let us move to the actual text. Look at the screen and listen carefully. Okay. One day, Nanak's father gave him some money and said, take this money and buy some goods and sell them and get good profit. Nanak agreed. and left the house to buy goods. On the way, he saw some sannyasis. They were starving. They looked pale and weak. Nanak spoke to them and came to know that they had not eaten anything for many days. Nanak gave the money which his father gave to the sannyasis. They blessed him and moved on. Nanak came back home. He told his father what he had done with the money. His father was fed up with his strange behavior. He sent him away to his sister Nanaki, who was living with her husband at Sultanpur in Punjab. Nanaki found a job for Nanak and he did his job well. Everyone was pleased with him. After some time, Nanak requested his father to send his servant Mardana to his place. Okay, children. Very nice. You all listened the lesson carefully. Now, it's your turn. What you are supposed to do means you have to repeat after me. Okay. I am going to read the text in chunks. You have to repeat after me. Shall we start, children? Very nice. One day, Nanak's father gave him some money and said, "Take this money and buy some goods and sell them and get good profit." Nanak agreed and left the house to buy goods. On the way, he saw some sannyasis. They were starving. They looked pale and weak. Nanak spoke to them and came to know that they had not eaten anything for many days. Nanak gave the money which his father gave to the sannyasis. They blessed him and moved on. Nanak came back home. He told his father what he had done with the money. His father was fed up with his strange behavior, he sent him away to his sister Nanaki, who was living with her husband at Sultanpur in Punjab. Nanaki found a job for Nanak and he did his job well. Everyone was pleased with him. After some time, Nanak requested his father to send his servant Mardana to his place. Well, children, thank you. You all read very nicely. Now, let us comprehend the text. We all know that Nanak was different from other children. Isn't it, children? Yes. While the children are playing, he used to sit in a place and always thinking about dog. Then Metha Kalu found a wife for him at the age of 14. Even after a marriage, did Nanak change? No. Isn't it? Look here, children. In the picture we can see. Yeah. Who is there in the picture? Metha Kalu and Nanak. So, after marriage also, Nanak didn't change. So, Nanak's father gave money for him. He gave some money for Nanak to buy goods, sell them and get good profit. Vyapara maadli, vyaparadalli nan maga todagli anta helibittu Nanak's father Metha Kalu gave money for Nanak. Gopa, go and buy some goods, you sell them and get profit and come back to home, he said. Guru Nanak, he agreed. Aitopaji, I will do. He agreed and left the house to buy goods. Look here. Nanak agreed to his father and he took money and left the house to buy the goods. Amele enaytu annodanna nodana. While going on the way to market, he saw some sannyasis. Sannyasis were starving. They were suffering from hunger. They were looking pale and weak. Look here, children. The sannyasis in the picture. Nanak saw some sannyasis. They were starving. They were looking weak. They were looking pale because the sannyasis had not eaten anything from many days. So, Nanak was a good boy. Isn't it? He was a good. He had lot of helping nature. He was thinking of God. He was thinking of humankind. So, what the bunny has given to the Nanak, he gave that money to the sannyasis. Nanak gave money for the sannyasis. Then sannyasis blessed him. Then Nanak went back to home and told to his father what had happened. His father was fed up. ಏನಪ್ಪ ಏನಾದರೂ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಾ ಏನೋ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಇವ ಏನೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಫೆಡ್ ಅಪ್. ಸೋ ನಾನಕ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಮೇತ ಕಾಲು ಸೆಂಡ್ ದ ನಾನಕ್ ಟು ದ ನಾನಕಿ. ಇನ್ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವುಮನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಕಲರ್ ಡ್ರೆಸ್. ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಅ ನಾನಕಿ, ಎಲ್ಡರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುರು ನಾನಕ್. Nanaki was living with her husband at Sultanpur in Punjab. Okay, Then Nanaki found a job for a Nanak. Nanak was sent to Nanaki, who was living with her husband at Sultanpur in Punjab. She found a job. Nanak was doing his job very well and he was pleased. All were pleased with his job. Again he got bored. Then he told his father Meta Kalu to send Mardana, who was their servant. He was getting bored. So he told his father Meta Kalu to send the Mardana. Mardana was their servant. He told his father to send Mardana, yes, to the Sultanpur, to Sultanpur. Okay, children, I think you understand the text. Shall I check the your comprehension? Okay, children, you are ready with the answers? Good. Your first question is, who gave money to the Nanak? Right, children, father gave money to the Nanak. Why did Nanak's father give money to him? Nanak's father gave money for him to buy some goods and sell them and to get some profit. Whom did Nanak see on the way? Nanak saw the sannyasis on the way. Who was the sister of Nanak? You're right. Nanaki was the sister of Nanak. Where and with whom did Nanaki live? Nanaki lived with her husband at Sultanpur. Who was their servant? Mardana was their servant. Very nice, children. Now it's grammar fun. You all are familiar with naming words and action words. Let us look into the naming words. A naming word, noun, is a name of a person, animal, place or thing. Anusha, cat, hospital, ball. Name of a person, animal, place or thing. Action word. Yes, an action word is a word expresses an action. Now, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಪದ. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್. ಓಕೆ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಎಸ್, ಪ್ಲೇಯಿಂಗ್, ಈಟಿಂಗ್, ಸ್ಲೀಪಿಂಗ್, ಎಸ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ನೌ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಸೈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ದ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ನೌನ್ಸ್ನ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. And underline the action words. Okay. I will read out the sentences for you. Circle the naming words and underline the action words. Children are playing in the park. Seema plays with her toys. I saw lotus floating in the pond. Rabbit is eating a carrot. A bird sings a song. Circle the nouns, underline the action words. Okay, you did very nice. Children park, Seema toys, lotus pond, rabbit carrot, bird song. These are the naming words. Let us come to the action words. Playing, plays, floating, eating, sings. Very nice, children. All of you have done good job. Yes. Finish this? Yes. The circled words are nouns, underlined words are action words. Now it's time for assignment. You have to read the textbook. You have to make a list of 4-letter words, 5-letter words, 6-letter words from the text we read in today's class. For example, 4-letter word S-E-L-L. 5-letter word N-A-N-A-K, Nanak. 6-letter word F-A-T-H-E-R. Likewise, You have to make a list of 4-letter words, 5-letter words and 6-letter words from the today's text. Okay children, I hope you enjoyed today's session. Let us meet in our next class. This is your teacher, B.B. Sahera. Assistant teacher, G.H.B.S. Lachankeri, Koppal Taluk and District. Take care children. Bye.
Anudina, anukshana, maniyellu kaliyona, kalikeya hosa hadiyali, jotegudi hecheya hakona, santasadi kaliyona, namma hemmeyayi classinali.
Yes sir.
Yes teacher.
Yes ma'am.